देश के प्रजातंत्र का नीति न्याय विवाले आड़त चेयाले अने वो जवाबदारी ये नीति कार्यान्वयन नीति शासकार्यान्वयन नीति न्यायान्वयन नीति चिंदे अति प्रतिपादनगा कार्यदेमो अनि ప్రజానికి తెలిసి ఇంత జన్మ రాయలు ఈ మహాసమయ సమావేశంలో పాల్గొంటారని నావుగా అర్థించుకుంటాను. ది లార్జ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ద డెలిగేట్స్ పార్టిసిపేషన్ ఇన్ దిస్ మీనింగ్ఫుల్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫస్ట్ తెలంగాణ స్టేట్ ఆల్ ఇండియా లాయర్స్ యూనియన్ కాన్ఫరెన్స్ recognize the fact that democracy, secularism, justice and socialism, which are basic features of the constitution of India, are signed by the Supreme Court way back, 43 years back, in Keshavananda Bharati. The preamble of the constitution, the sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic Republic India. To render social justice, social, economic and political to the people of the country. So three limbs of the constitution. The subject given to me is working of the Indian Constitution. It would be possible for me to address all the relevant aspects of the working of the Indian Constitution today. But I have to highlight certain important aspects with reference to the theme of the conference to defend the basic features of the Constitution which I had already referred to, which contained in the preamble of the Constitution. Is a big prelude. It is evident. Therefore, the All India Lawyers Union Conference and organization, its development, its need, its movement is very, very relevant and pertinent in the present day. I told you that I am very happy today because as a lawyer, as an activist, committed to the Constitution, concerned to the people of this country, I thought the All India Lawyers Union will uphold the constitutional mandate for good governance of the people of the country by the legislature, the executive, and the judiciary. The lawyers today have to play very important role to defend the democracy in India. Democracy is the cornerstone of the Constitution. Yes, you have told it clearly. The parliamentary democracy is very stable, very strong in India, strong in the world. But we are targeting to tell. Part 3, Article 14, 15, 16, 1921, relative to the directives of state policy. Both Part 3 and Part 4, these Part 3 is the fundamental rights, Part 4 of the directives of state policy, Part 2, the human rights of the people of the country. So, there is a demarcation under Article 50 of the Constitution of India. That demarcation of the functions of three limbs of the Constitution, that is the working of the Indian Constitution. The legislature, keeping in view the constitutional laudable concept and philosophy of rendering justice socially, economic and political to the people of the country, it is the basic piece of the Constitution. They are going to enact the law. There is no doubt about enacting the law after 66 years of the a political document was interpreted by several judges in the Gomez case way back in 1984 that the constitution is a political document. That's what Naga Mohan Das was telling in his speech. All India Lawyers Union does not belong to any political party. It is not a legal cell of any political organization in India. Nonetheless, it does not mean to say because they do not have a politics. The politics which he has referred to, according to my understanding, is the interpretation made by the Supreme Court, which is independent and vibrant justice to be delivered to the people of the country, the judiciary, they interpreted the constitution is a political document. A political document because it speaks of democracy, it speaks of secularism, it speaks of socialism and justice. So legislation connects the law, is the working of the constitution. The executive required to implement the law, and the judiciary has to overview the functioning of both the legislature and the executive. There is no bar, there is no prohibition for the Indian judiciary. Indian judiciary means not exclusively the judges. Judiciary means the lawyers, part of the Indian judiciary, that there is no bar. If the legislature enacts the law, if the legislature does not discharge their function, the political executive is implementing to achieve the constitutional object in the philosophy and the social justice to the people of the country, the judiciary is required to interfere. This is what has been done by the Indian judiciary right from 1951, the Champakadore case. Yes? 1951 Supreme Court, the weapon class certificate issued by the Tamil Nadu state government, weapon class people who are not getting seats in education institutions, please deserve that kind of class to bring those of people, that section of people, on par with the people who can get seats on the basis of their belief. They are not in a position to secure the seat in education institution. Education is most important. Therefore, it is the duty of the state government issued the circular. The constitutional bench of the Supreme Court has said, the judgment of the Supreme Court has said it is unconstitutional. But the parliament did not keep quiet. Parliament stepped in and amended the fifth constitutional amendment to the Constitution of India. So this is the working of the constitution. What I am trying to tell you today is, today there is no death for the laws, there is no death for the constitutional philosophy for good governance to the people of the country. When we got the independence, liberated from the colonial rule, the population was 39 crores. Today the population of the country is second to China in Asian continent. 127 crores, 72 lakhs and odd population in India from Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari. We have got so many problems. Rightly, Naga Mohan Das said in his speech that we are not the cynical. All India Lawyers Union or its members are not cynical today if we tell the problems of rent to the people of the country. At the same time, we recognize the achievements made by the successive responsible governments, both in the parliament and the state legislature, implementation of the philosophy of the constitution. But there are so many areas which are unattended, required to be attended. That is why this kind of conference will definitely open the minds of the responsible government to come forward, think over, ponder over, and see that working of the constitution, the constitution is moving towards which direction. This is because Ranjan Bhattacharya was mentally, while interpreting Article 14, 16 of the Constitution of India, the constitutional bench of the Supreme Court, for no one but a employee who has been employed despite the fact the Article 309 of the Constitution of India, recruitment, route and public employment is required to be provided is the constitutional obligation on the part of the responsible governments. Recruitment rules and cadastrant in the state government, public sector undertaking and statutory corporations are not filled up. Unemployment problem is growing to the Himalayan mountains. And unemployment, with unemployment people cannot be allowed to leave. It is not possible. It is not a sarkar magic. Without taking water, without taking food, the people can leave. So therefore, the Supreme Court, the Gopala case, regarding 1986 Supreme Court, the Constitutional Bench, interpreting Part 3 and Part 4 of the Constitution of India, the rights of the people of the country, particularly the stone buildings, interpreted, that's why, because what Acharya was telling, Article 21 means it is not biological existence, it is not animal existence. The right is dignity. The dignity is the part of paternity, the basic which of the Constitution, the preamble of the Constitution. So therefore, today, you are required, you are employing people. Yes, yes, it is right to say. What in this case, you can't say the inaction is a part of the government. You employ these unemployed people. They are required to leave and you extract work. And exploitation of the unemployed youth is not permitted. The Supreme Court way back in 1982. Yes, sir, James case has said. Constitution has been said. You are not invited, your entry is back road entry. You are not inside in the back door. But I am justified, I have taken up that issue in the industrial adjudication. And I said, industrial adjudication, any country for development, the agriculture based economy country like India, agriculture is important, industry is important. Agriculture is also a major industry in India. Nobody knows it. Knows it, but then suddenly it is fighting. 74% of the population live in India. 56% of the agricultural labor, 26% of the land holding. So, agriculture is an industry. Today, all the agricultural laborers are migrating from the rural India to the metropolitan area today. That is because of the policy which is being pursued and implemented. So therefore, I am at the point, either in the any industry or in a sponsored government, if the recruitment does not take place and you employ them, exploit perennial nature of power, and they are all citizenry of the country, they are entitled to a source of income. The source of income is the basic tenet for liberty. Without source of income, there cannot be a livelihood. This is what is said by another constitutional bench in Ulva case, paragraph 32 of the constitutional bench. It has said, a meaningful life, a liberty, it is guaranteed in the constitution. That is the working of the Indian constitution. The paternity, the liberty, the equality, all these are intact in the Indian constitution. But you say, that your backdoor entry, and there is no source of income. What should happen to him? The Indian Penal Code does not permit a committing suicide. It is an offense. So if government, responsible government, in agricultural labor, there is no source of income. Unemployed youth, there is no source of income. What should happen to him? So therefore, in that context, because Bhattacharya is right in Delhi, that the backdoor entry is not the instance of the work the employees. It is the front and backdoor entry, right? But you have applied them, you should have recognized your services. He is the grievance of the All India Bias Union President. This fact is required to be reconsidered in my humble view. I am working the Indian Constitution. My dear friends, Constitution is for whom? Constitution speaks of democracy. Democracy means what? Democracy, either a parliamentary democracy or the people's democracy in Asian continent like China, USSR, India. The total difference will be there. But some of our brothers and sisters don't agree with that. They don't agree without understanding the gamut of the real democracy. The real democracy, whether parliamentary democracy, real democracy is the people's democracy, is required to be tested from different viewpoints. A multi-party system, like India, a person who is marginally more votes than multi-contestant candidate, that will become majority. That majority is the majority of the people is the question. So that is what parliamentary democracy is. But people's democracy is not like that. People's democracy, the approval from the people of that country and that state and that constituency. So parliamentary democracy and the people's democracy. I am not saying that parliamentary democracy is functioning or not. I leave it for you. Decide. I leave it to you. If 68 years of independence, liberating the country from the colonial rule by all stalwarts, the war of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister, Vallabhbhai Patel, the steel man of the country, the Home Minister, Rajendra Prasad Mango, the great stalwart, the first president of India. Series of persons who have governed us, who held the post. Both the parliaments and the state governments are elections for 5 years. It's going on sometimes less than 5 years. It has gone on. That is the system working of the Indian Constitution. So, democracy for the people, by the people, of the people. That means each person that was created along with Article 14 of the Constitution of India, that was created along with the preamble of the Constitution. The preamble says the socialist India. Article 14 says equality, equal protection of laws, equal opportunities to men and the women in Article 39A of the Constitution of India. So, a hackman, a slum brother, a person who is after abolishing the prelipas, the Maharashtra, the kings, 1971, 1110. So today, the working of the Indian Constitution and the constitutional scheme means every citizen from president to the common man is equal and equal opportunity must be given. So, every man, that's what the architect of the Constitution, America, who has said, when in the Constituent Assembly on 22nd November 1949, he said, what he said? We are moving from the democracy, the parliamentary, the political democracy, to the social democracy. What do you mean by that? He wanted to say and give a message that one man, one value, one man, one value, exercise of your franchise, that does not mean, it does not amount to the social democracy. Social democracy means a man in the slum, man in the great palace, are equal. Equal opportunity must be given. And material resource is belong to the common good, Article 39B. That is why the bank nationalization. That is why abolition of the Jamindari system way back, right from 1952. 52 in Karnataka, there is something statute pretending an agricultural tenant that has been enlarged in the occupant right. That has happened in Calcutta, West Bengal. That has happened in the Bihar. That is happening in different parts of the country because the interpretation of the part 3 keeping in view 19 one year right to own the private property is a fundamental right that has been deleted by 34th constitutional amendment and the first constitutional amendment, the great the first prime minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, he has said in the provincial parliament, he has addressed and told his speech has been extracted by the constitutional bench of the Supreme Court in Gomagas case. He has said, I am not a jamindar, neither am I a capitalist, nor a tenant. But to achieve part 3 and part 4, equality and equal opportunity, unless the land being a material resource, the country based upon the agricultural based economy, then unless the land holding is given to the land holder, there will not be a sufficient agriculture produce. If agriculture produce is not there, the economy of the country will crumble down. And to achieve the mandate of Part 3 of equality and equal opportunity to all the people of the country, the land reforms is very, very important. It is the working of the Indian Constitution. That is why the Land Reforms Act have been amended and put in the ninth schedule of the Constitution of India. That is the great, the contribution of the great, the socialist thinker politicians who are the statesmen today. The generation is taking place. So democracy is a very, very, very important aspect. I can elaborate and speak on the democracy for hours together, but what of time I don't want to go into the details of that aspect, I leave it at that stage. So democracy must be defended. Who has to defend it? Today the second first independence war over. Second stage which we have reached today, if we don't defend the democracy today, there will not be good governance of the responsible government. For which lawyers, Mahatma Gandhi, Ambedkar, Nehru played a pivotal role to liberate the country from the colonial rule of more than 200 years. Today, you are the champions. You must be the forefront, particularly the young members of the lawyers today. Must think of the country in democracy, otherwise the country will go to the great danger. I am speaking as a sitting judge of the Supreme Court of all seriousness. The country, Nagamohan Das has highlighted, 9 states in the country today, the Naxalism, Maoism and terrorism. In a democratic country, vast geographical area, 127 crores of population, governance and the constitution, the material resource is not lacking in this country, the land is the material, forest is a material produce, material resource, the mineral is a material resource, mineral is very much available, I am told in Khammam today. Mineral in Nalagonda is very much available today. Material resource of iron, raw material, the bauxite, the copper, the polystyrene, the diamond, what not. Everything available in this country. Still, 9 states are being rampant with this Maoist, Naxalites. What is the problem? Why? Who are they? They are all double language. They are all educated people. They are all frustrated in life. That means no answer for these. There is an answer. Answer is to make the responsible people, the legislature and the executive, including the judiciary. If we have It is the lawyers alone can work as a watchdog and point out this decision, this law, this non-implementation is affecting the growth and development of the country. Please, government, for that you are required to go and tell the people today, not only practicing inside the court, outside the court, it's the job, otherwise you lose the country, the democracy. So therefore, my dear friends, yes, lawyers are professionals. You have been playing very important role in development of law and evolution of law. Without lawyers, they just cannot function at all. They just cannot render judgment. Take history, either the Privy Council or the Federal Court, or the State High Court, or the Supreme Court. Right from 1950, A.K. Gopala's case. A.K. Gopala's case, a farmer, a proletarian leader, a teacher became a proletarian leader, a parliament member, his liberty has been curtailed. Great Nambiar, the senior lawyer, argued the case. His preventive detention. The preventive detention was upheld. They have said, interpreted Article 14 and 19 of the Constitution of India in a different way. The minority was the law. That minority judgment has become the minority within short time, within 1969, Supreme Court. That means it is the contribution of the lawyers in the Indian courts, the judiciary, could able to afford for three rights of the people of the country. You cannot prevent detention without following the due process of law. Is the law enacted by the Supreme Court, for which it is the lawyers alone are responsible. I can very courageously tell you your presence. So therefore, my dear friends, your role to protect wherever the Indian working of the Constitution derives, you bring them to the correct lines. That is the role of the All India Lawyers Union, because you are all wedded to the democracy, you are wedded to the socialism, you are wedded to the justice. That's one area. The secularism today, Mr. Nakamondas did not elaborate it. What is secularism? State must be neutral. Yes? Part 3. The religious rights, freedom of speech, freedom of practice of religious tenets is guaranteed in the Constitution. This was exactly said in Champakadaraya's case. You can't take away the rights of the religious head, it violates Article 29.2 of the Constitution. So, religious rights are intact under the Constitution. It is your home affair, it is your personal affair. We are not doing that. So, secularism threat, a multi-religion country. It is not one religion which is prevalent in the country. A vast country like India, a pluralist society, multi-religion country, multi-caste, multi-subcaste, there is a Hindu people, the Islam, the Jains, the Christians, all Jains, everybody is there, what their own role to play in the development. You are deviating, we will not allow, this is the constitutional mandate. It is the constitutional mandate which has been approved by the parliament and accepted by the people, and governance is taking place for the last 66 years. We will not allow to erode the demolition of secularism in despite the constitutional benches of the Supreme Court. Right from 1958, when Keshe Devaru case, Supreme Court has said, Article 17 of the Constitution, untouchability is abolished. Untouchability today is in practice. Can it be tolerated? That's why the Constitution bench of Supreme Court. Can it be tolerated if any thing which is going to be damaged to the secularism? Secularism is interpreted by seven judges in Bombay State. Then, if you do trample that, will it not amount to violation of rule of law? Will it not affect the working of the Indian Constitution? Is another thought for the members of the bar, and particularly my sisters who are large member. I'll come to your topic. What is Article 15? Equality. Equal opportunity is the constitutional concept, irrespective of the caste, the creed, the religion. Is there any property raised in your favor except economic transaction? What kind of system, society, societal order, the social order, equality and equal opportunity? 50% of the population of the women, my sisters and mothers who are in India, and reservation 243 of the 11th schedule and the amendment 73rd and 74th constitutional amendment, the reservation of women in the village panchayat, reservation in cooperative society, the reservation in public employment, 33.13%. Why 33.13% and 50% are there? Why not 50%? This is, you are required to say, in a big way, both the people educate. We are not living in an oligarchy system. Gender justice is not allowed to have perpetuated in this country, on this, in this land, of Rama and Mahabharata were required. Is it okay? So therefore, my dear sister, I am very happy to see you. This side, both the male lawyers, this side, one fourth you are there. I am very happy. You are sufficient. You are a lucky boy. You please proceed. Yes. We have got the Indian Constitution, equality, working place. Yes, my friend is Bhattacharya, was it critical? Yes, I have to accept it. But at the same time, the contribution of the Supreme Court and the High Court, please acknowledge it. Yes. Please acknowledge it. Yes, please acknowledge it. What? The Rajasthan case, working workplace, women are not safe. No law, despite the constitution, special law must be made, Article 15.3, work of the child and the woman, is the constitutional working of the constitution. The Vishakha's case is the case the Supreme Court undergoes the copy. The judiciary, which is part of the constitution for good governance, part of the state definition of Article 12 of the constitution, they are very much concerned, they are very much committed to the woman development and woman protection in this country. That is why Vishakha's case, you must have all read, I don't want to read it today. Now, every institution today, there must be a committee. And maybe some issues of the committee giving a pass of rights, etc. I have not read that. But they reach a protection to women that is not sufficient. That is only to the working place woman. But woman who is working in the rural area, please think of them. They don't have the maternity home. They don't have the health care. They don't have the right of widowhood to get the pension. They don't have the proper nutritious food. For them, please book the village, establish a law clinic. That's what my brother Justice, the Acute Justice, Muslim study. Today, there are so many avenues for the lawyers to defend the constitution, make the working of the Indian constitution. My sister, please think of the village woman and slum woman. Go there, educate, tell them, you have got all the rights in the constitution. We are here to protect you both in the executive office, in the court, outside the court. We are here to take care of you. Please give them and help them. And that way you can do justice, you can make the working of the constitution. I hope and trust my woman, sister, lawyer, about the lawyer students to do that. My dear friends, I heard somewhere, and it's a fact, education, not known that very cleverly, has said, the literate are not legal literates. Yes, it's a very beautiful. That's a fact. Yes. So that's why today lawyers' profession is addressed as honorable and noble profession. No other profession. Doctors are not. Politicians are not noble. They are all statesmen. They are all good people. They are the masters of the people to enact the law, implement the law, frame the policy, govern the people. But the lawyer, you are the person, advisor to the President of India. Meet the people. Wipe out the tears of our sisters and the brothers in the agriculture. What a happiness. What a happiness you get. So that is what I meant. The second, the liberation of the country from this onslaught of exploitation, unemployment problem, people suffering, the agriculturists are starving, agriculturists are committing suicide. Go to the rescue to see that, educate by creating legal clinics. Make use of my best good friend, very dynamic Chief Justice of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Make use of him. Take him to all the places. You see, he was traveled from Andhra Pradesh, Allahabad, to participate in a conference like this. It is a great good for all India Rights Union to take forward. Don't stop after 2 days conference. Please take forward and take up the issues of videos. Take up the issues of differently abled persons. Take up the cause of the aged people who have worked the law. Take the cause of harassed woman at the hands of the husband. Conduct conciliation, mediation. That you do, that you will be doing great. Then justice to the people of the this is the state. I have exceeded more than 45 minutes. I don't want to hold you because the hungry lions and the hungry stomachs are very difficult. So therefore I must be aware of this fact that I will be before the hungry lions, then it will be difficult. The justice is not a justice concept. Justice what? That's the preamble. Justice is social. Justice is economic. Justice is political. All these things can be obtained from the court. No? Then if you say yes, only 3% of people are before the courts today out of 127. But 50%, more than 50% of the people are below the poverty line. My mother's, I come from a village, Nagamon Das and me. Every fortnight or 3 weeks, I would visit my village. I could see their brains, I could see their face, I could see their bodies. They are all only bones and skeletons, but not the flesh. That is the problem. I worry for them. I work for them. I operate from Delhi to teleport to the hospitals of his wife. As my judgment is being alternative, case is cited. Please tell me, if your father takes you to the lawyer, he would have been known in the Kirtan, Pin and the Karnataka state and some judges who have heard me. But today, Gopala Gowda justice in the hearts of many, many people of this country. This is. I want to bring home the point of my sisters and brothers, sisters and brothers. Please do this. See how love and affection the generates. How you get this happy and satisfaction. Do you think that at this age, I am going to retire another 8 months? I worked until 4:50. I was in Bangalore last week. Day before yesterday, the midnight, again 5 o'clock, 4:10. 5 minutes late, my flight was missing. My private secretary was asking, book the ticket to the Indigo at 7 o'clock. I reached the Hyderabad at 10 o'clock. So it is not the stress and strain. The stress and strain after seeing you all within a day, watch out. So therefore, I want it. I am telling you, Ms. Raghavan has retired as a high court judge. Now he is practicing Supreme Court. He is going around the country. I am telling you, I will join with you after the retirement. This is my desire. I want you to train the youth of the country. It is my desire to make the young and energetic lawyers, army of the lawyers, to face and take up the cause of the millions and millions of the people of this country, to bring home the sense to the people who are governing the country, either the members of the parliament or the legislature, the people of, you must make the vibrant for good governance and working on the constitution. We all will do that. I will come and join you. I am very happy. I was there. My friend, good friend, a senior friend, Radhakrishna, khammam means Radhakrishna for me. Radhakrishna is not there. I will go and see him. You all get inspiration from the speeches delivered by the eminent speaker. And look at the upsurge going on in this place. Look at the inspiration. It's 2 o'clock. You are not here, baby. You are angry now. I am also very much hungry. I took one day because I am a sugar patient. I took one chocolate. I should have taken some more chocolate, not available here. But anyway, this kind of message, the inspiration, you must take. You must work for the people, work for the nation, work for the fraternity, work for protection of the constitutional institutions like parliament, the judiciary, the officers which are responsible. There is a figure, bring home the figure, make them to rewrite the constitutional philosophy of giving justice in the agriculture sector, in the education sector, in the industrial sector, to see that the 39B, the material exposed to the common good. And Raghavan Das said the commercialization. Yes. Bhattacharya also said commercialization. Disinvestment, private entrepreneurs are in the place. Nonetheless, the word socialist, Article 38, 44 Constitution Amendment, social order is still intact. So this kind of the existing change of the public sector to private entrepreneurs are not in a position to give answer to the people and fulfill the aspirations of the people that will pay, then you are for that required to tell, educate, bring legal awareness, make them to come to the forefront, make them to realize their folly, make them to realize their rights, make them to realize, participate. That you can do like Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, and the various Dr. Ambedkar, and we all must follow the constitutional mandate for making the working of the constitution for betterment of the welfare, to achieve the welfare state, the welfare of the country. I wanted to conclude by reading what Jawaharlal Nehru said about the constitution. The constitution is after all some kind of legal body given to the ways of the government and life of the people. Please remember. The ways of the government and the life of the people. A constitution, if it is out of touch with the people life, the aims and aspirations becomes rather empty. If it falls behind those aims, it drags the people down. You should something ahead to keep people's eyes and minds made up to a certain high mark. Remember this, that while we want this constitution, to be as a solid and as a permanent structure as we can make it, there should be a certain flexibility. If you make anything rigid and permanent, you stop a nation's growth, the growth of a living, vital, organic people. So make the other responsible persons who are governing us, this what Pandit Jawaharlal said way back in 1915. Please remember this, make them to realize and govern the people of the country, otherwise the constitution is an empty formality. That we will not allow. I hope and trust Bhattacharya and his leadership, and here our friend President, the Vidyasagar and Satyanarayana, the army and the people like you will not do that. You will take up the movement forward and work for the people of the country to make the country very strong and do away with injustice which is being caused to the weaker section, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, the woman and the backward class and the people who are being trampled in the hands of the big people. Vested interest must be broken. That is possible. Colonial rule is thrown away. The vested interest also can be thrown away. Please do that. Thank you very much.